happening. No gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up, you guys? Craft Farms here, and welcome back to another video. So, we are back on Dakota Plains today. I did do a little bit of a change here. I brought in the Case 2388. Basically, I copied all of the XYZs from the other combine that we had, and then just did some copying and pasting in the XML and whatnot. And now we got a 2388 instead of a 5130. I had been using this on a different save game, and it was dirty, and it had a little bit of corn in it yet, so I had to get the GMC truck out and take it and put it into the silo. It was like 3,000 liters, so wasn't much, but it was definitely a little bit there. Anyway, I did a bunch of off-camera cultivating. And now we are finishing cultivating. And I need my timer going. We are going to finish cultivating and possibly get started on planting. It shouldn't take too terribly long to do all this cultivating, so hopefully we'll get some planting done or started as well. Another thing that I also swapped out is the planter. This is Random Sparks' remake of the planter that we had before. It's the exact same, just given new AO textures and works with dirt and whatever. And basically, it had the same file name as the old one, so I just replaced it. And so now it's in the exact same spot. I didn't even have to do any changes to it to get that one to work, so. So now every single machine that we have works with dirt. Before, the only thing that didn't was the corn planter, but now that also works with dirt, so everything will get dirty. Oh, I guess our pickup doesn't. The pickup is the only thing that does not get dirty. So, but whatever. I may actually swap that out for one of my K30s as well, but we'll see, I guess. I do kind of want to take the K30 and make it color selectable, but disengage, not engage. But I think I would have to join the box and the cab together first, so I'd have to go back into Blender. But I don't know for sure if I'd have to join it together or not. Cause I'm not sure if I have the two pieces separated, I'd have to talk to some people about it first, or do some research or something. But I don't know. I'll find out, I guess. And so we do actually own some other fields around here. We own field 16, which is in wheat, so we may go and combine that. 24 is in grass, so nothing really there. 16, I think, is the only other one that we own. So might go and combine that, but then probably won't do much field work on it since it's so far away. But could go combine it and get some extra wheat, so that may be a possibility. Take the combine and trucks over there. I do have withering turned off, so it wouldn't wither, and technically we could combine the cornfield too if we really wanted, but probably won't. I don't know, we'll see, I guess. We'll just kind of see what happens. We should have enough crop here, though. And really, we don't have to do too many upgrades, just kind of a bigger cultivator is really about the only thing that would be, you know, a want. You know, I do have thought, I have been thinking about just like keeping all of the equipment except, you know, upgrading this cultivator to something a little bigger. Otherwise, keeping all of this equipment and, like, you know, we can save money to buy the larger farm and then just save money to buy all new equipment for that farm. And then, so, like, you know, we'd have all of the other more expensive, much larger equipment up here, but then down here is kind of like, we can keep it old school, we can, you know, we can run fields 29, 30, 31, 32, and 33 with all of this equipment that we have here, and just kind of, excuse me, kind of keep a mix of, like, you know, old school and modern. But I don't know, we'll see what happens, I guess. It would be neat to do, but I don't know if we'll do it. I mean, we might keep some of this old equipment around and take it to the other farm to use, or even leave it here just to use other times or something. I mean, I don't know. We'll do something with it. Maybe we'll sell it, maybe we'll keep it. Who knows? The cultivator that I want to pick up is basically a larger version of this one. Basically a larger version of this one, the KPS-8. And right now we're running the KPS-4, so that is a 4 meter working with, so I'm assuming this has, yep, that has an 8 meter. So, twice the size. So that'd be a nice upgrade, but that'll be after harvest, because that would take, like, all of our money. So, if we bought it right now. So that'll have to wait until after harvest, after we sell our grain. Because I think we're doing sunflowers and, or something like that. Let's see, probably soybeans. I think what we'll do is we'll do a kind of a mix. So this field here we'll put in as rye. And then field 32 will kind of split into two. Then we can do sunflower, part sunflowers, part soybeans. Because I'm pretty sure sunflowers are on here. And soybeans. Yeah, soybeans and sunflowers are both on here. So this field will do the whole thing in rye. And then that other field will split. Half of it will be soybeans. The other half will be sunflowers. So there will be a lot of grain drill work this spring, and then a lot of corn head work in the fall. This tractor is going to be like the spraying tractor mostly, so this guy will take back and we'll wash everything off, and then we'll put the cultivator away. We'll get out. We'll get the other Oliver hooked up to the drill. Get the Alice hooked up to the corn planter, and then we'll be all ready for spring. Just remembered I gotta take a screenshot here before we finish. Almost didn't. Alright. So we're gonna lift that up. We're gonna fold these. Fold. then we're gonna head up to the farm. See, do we need any fuel? Nope, we are good on fuel. That's one thing I've kind of noticed is, like, in 15, things don't use fuel hardly at all, like, compared to 13. I mean, in 13, things use fuel quite a lot, but here, they just don't use fuel at all, hardly. Does this thing have flashers on it? It does. We do need to repair this as well. Mainly the cultivator, but we can do that later because our, well, we can pull our fuel tank out once we move the tractors. Got a floating tree there. I still haven't edited this to get rid of this gate and some of this fence here. I was mainly just going to remove that panel there, because then that'll give us enough room to get in with the headers and whatnot. I mean, it's pretty close right now. They almost fit, so it wouldn't take a whole lot more to make them fit. Okay, so we're going to fire up this stuff. Okay, so this guy will go on there. We're gonna put our duals on. Whoa, wrong direction. Big time wrong direction. Okay, so we need to change this to rye. And then, oh yeah, we need to put down some seed and fertilizer because we have neither at this farm. So we're just going to do some placeables here. That's lime. We don't need that. So we need the fertilizer tank. Can go on that end. And the seed pallets can go on that end. So we're selected on rye. And of course that thing's acting ridiculous. Oh. Much way. Helps to have the wheels down. Although on this planter it doesn't. That planter's terrible. Okay, so now we're gonna pull this over here and wash it, because we have to hook this up to the sprayer so that way we can get the corn planter out. I also want to fix this door and make it that walkthrough door so it's shut, so that way it's not clipping through the normal door, the big doors. They're all over nice and shiny again. Okay, so now we're gonna move this tractor. We're just gonna back it up a little bit here. I still haven't changed the sounds on this either. We're gonna run over here and get our pickup. I don't know why my frames are so low. So we're gonna run over and grab our fuel trailer here. Not to refill fuel in anything, but just to, whoa. Holy crap, 10% damage just for me braking? Wow. Damage mod is definitely very touchy. I hate that about it. Oh, fix the Atlas as well there. Okay, let's see. Repair. KPS4 is repaired. And I think we're just going to pull this underneath here. fine right there. We can get this cultivator put away. This will go in front of the red truck. Right there will do. So I'll have to pull that out again at harvest, but that's what happens when you have a smaller shed. I mean, we could use the other one, but why? I like this shed a whole lot better. This shed is a lot nicer, so we're going to use it instead. Okay, and then we're gonna get this filled up as well. So that way this thing is ready to rock once we are done planting. Okay, hook onto the corn planter. We need to change this to soybean. There we go. I probably could have gotten by with the two-wheel drive 8030, but that's right, this thing needs to be unfolded so it, or maybe not, I don't know. I wish this thing didn't have the particles as you drive. I think it is just like some driving particles, so I think they can be deleted. Okay, so what are we at for time here? Oh wow, we're only at 17 minutes. Okay, well, and I guess we can get started on some planting here. Go ahead and we'll go start planting some rye. Alright. Jeez, this thing shakes. It's a nice model, but it's definitely got its issues. But it does work nice, so can't go wrong, I guess. It works and looks good, so. And it was ready, dirt ready. Just needed to script it in and add spec maps to it. Are you kidding me? You're gonna roll all the way down. Really? You stupid thing. That is the thing that I hate the most about this planter. It is so dumb. So dumb. It just rolls right along. That's why I wish I could keep it on, you know, like this, but it won't fit through the gate. at this size, so I really can't keep it this size. Anyhow, let's get started here. We're gonna bring this down a ways. So get all this stuff away. Oh, is this fertilizing? Kinda looks like it almost. And it does have working markers too. Well, they go out, they don't work, but they do go out. And they don't function. They do work, but they don't function. That doesn't make a whole lot more sense either, but whatever. It is removing grass as well, so that's good. And that's kind of why I'm overlapping, because there is field underneath of some grass. Yeah, they don't really go down far enough to do anything, so oh well, I guess. Its nodes are definitely way off. I don't know why, but like, equipment, when you go one direction, it, holy crap, those are spinning fast. Jeez. Anyway, I don't know why, but like, when you go one direction, you, like it, you know, like with headers, it'll combine like two rows farther than the header is, but then when you go the other direction, it doesn't want to combine. Like it combines more than the header is. Okay. It combines a larger area than the header covers, and then when you go the other direction, see like here, now it's not wanting to go all the way over. It's so weird how this stuff works sometimes, but I guess that's how it works. Tractor is getting dirty a lot faster than the planter is, though. But oh well. I think I have the dirt duration set the same. Pretty sure the planter is set to 30. That's what the tractor is at. 30 is kind of what I've found works the best. I mean, it doesn't get dirty like instantly, but it also doesn't take ages. But it seems like different mods work differently in terms of like your dirt duration. Like it could be 30, you know, it's 30 on this tractor and it's dirty already, and it's 30 on the planter, but the planter isn't quite dirty. So it's just kind of weird how that works out sometimes. So we'll be able to get this field open. Which we did, so I guess now we'll kind of do some up and down passes. Yeah, see, it's like the node shifts. It's kind of weird, but So we'll just skip passes here. Makes turning a whole lot easier.
Ah,
wrong button. There we go. That's the right one. Planter kind of slid there a little bit. Actually not taking all that long to plant. Tadger joint needs to go down just a little for this planter. I don't know if it's on the tractor or on the planter itself, but I'd have to do some looking at that. See, maybe it is this tractor, or maybe it's just the planter. Let's see, what do we have for time? So, we're almost done. Yeah, I think this is fertilizing as we go, I'm not sure. But, I think what we're going to do is I'm gonna flip this thing around, and in the next video we'll finish planting the rye, and then maybe start on the sunflowers. We'll probably just come down here, kind of figure out what's between, kind of what's in the middle here, kind of where the center is, and then just go straight up or something. I don't know. We'll figure something out, but that is going to do it for this video. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Be sure to subscribe if you like what you see. Be sure to turn on the post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. Be sure to check out down below in the description for my PC specs, my upload schedule, as well as links to all of my social medias and some other cool YouTube channels that are worth taking a look at. Thanks for watching, you guys, and as always, we'll see you tomorrow.